The sophisticated instruments of the Mars rover Curiosity are still working and have formed the basis for instrumentation for future rovers, including the Perseverance rover. Here is an in-depth explanation of how those instruments work and how they were improved upon, updated, and integrated into the Perseverance rover. Medley is an integral part of the science of the heat shield of the rover. It is built into the heat shield that protects the rover during its descent through the Martian atmosphere, and is part of both the Curiosity and Perseverance rovers. Medley collected engineering data during Curiosity's high-speed, extremely hot entry into the Martian atmosphere. This information told engineers how well the heat shield performed. Medley is composed of two parts, MISP, measuring heat, and MEADS, measuring pressure. When the spacecraft faces extreme heat during entry into the Martian atmosphere, MISP measures how hot it gets at different depths in the spacecraft's heat shield material. MEADS measures the atmospheric pressure on the heat shield during entry and descent. The MEADS pressure sensors are arranged in a special cross pattern. This cross pattern allows engineers to determine the spacecraft's orientation. Using Medley data from Curiosity's plunge into the Martian atmosphere, scientists improved designs for future Mars-bound spacecraft. Medley 2 was the second heat shield sensor system and was used on the Perseverance rover. Its purpose was the same as Medley, but with some updated electronics. This time, Medley also included instrumentation on the back shell, in addition to the front leading side of the heat shield. Medley 2 includes 17 thermocouples, 3 heat flux sensors, and 17 pressure transducers, as well as all the electronics and hardware that were needed to record the heat and pressure experienced during the entry through the Martian atmosphere. Embedded thermocouples determined how much of the heat shield insulation burned away. Heat flux sensors measure heat flow or conductivity of a surface. This kind of data may allow as much as 35% lighter heat shields to be developed in the future. Medley on Curiosity did not measure heat flux, so this was a first on Perseverance. On the Curiosity rover, the instrument that fires a laser at rocks is called ChemCam. The updated version on Perseverance rover is called SuperCam. ChemCam and SuperCam both fire pulses of a laser at a target such as a rock. The ChemCam and SuperCam instruments are very similar at first glance, but internally, almost every part has been redesigned, so SuperCam will yield even more detail than ChemCam. Both instruments use laser-induced breakdown spectroscopy, or LIBS. The resulting plasma expansion generated by the SuperCam laser generates a shock wave when it hits the target, which both removes obscuring dust and can also be recorded with the SuperCam microphone. The different sounds that the laser makes when it hits a target can help determine properties of the target. Another of SuperCam's upgraded mineralogy techniques is Raman spectroscopy, which uses a laser to stimulate molecules on the surface of a rock or soil. It is a softer green laser beam compared to Curiosity's pulses that blast the surface. Although both Curiosity and Perseverance use laser-induced breakdown spectroscopy, Perseverance's green laser light gives it the ability to determine if there are minerals that formed in the presence of water. It can also identify which elements in the Martian dust may be harmful to humans. In both cases, energy from the laser excites a pinhead-sized spot on the target into glowing, ionized gas called plasma. Spectrometers in the instrument analyze the spectrum of light emitted by the plasma to identify chemical elements in the target. Different elements glow in different wavelengths or colors. This is laser-induced breakdown spectroscopy. Both the ChemCam and SuperCam instruments are composed of two parts. First is the body unit. which goes inside the body on each of the rovers and contains spectrographs for analyzing the ionized gas. The other is located on the mast and contains the laser, imager, and telescope. An optical fiber from the mast unit delivers the telescope's observations to the body unit. Both ChemCam and SuperCam possess similar capabilities, except the remote microimager on SuperCam produces images that are in color, rather than black and white like ChemCam. In addition, SuperCam's upgraded electronics include several additional observation techniques, high-resolution color imaging, and acoustic recording. When the Curiosity rover descended into the Martian surface, a camera called the Mars Descent Imager, or MARDI, captured the descent on video. MARDI is a fixed-focus color camera pointing down and even with Curiosity's chassis. MARDI recorded high-resolution video during Curiosity's landing on Mars. MARDI took color video, a first for Mars exploration, during the rover's descent toward the surface. And it took 5 frames per second video stream of high-resolution overhead views of the landing site. Perseverance added a whole lot of updated and improved camera systems. For instance, uplook cameras were mounted on the back shell of Perseverance to see the parachute's inflation and deployment. Then, mounted on the deck of the rover, was another uplook camera, looking upward at the descent stage during the sky crane maneuver. And looking down on the rover during the sky crane maneuver. Curiosity did not have these cameras, so this was a first for Perseverance. Similar to Curiosity, however, Perseverance also had a downlook camera, looking downward at the landing site during the descent. Curiosity has basic front and rear has cams, 4 mounted on the front and 2 on the rear of the rover. Perseverance's has cams were newly developed, however, for greater detection of potential driving hazards to the front and rear of the rover. When driving, Perseverance stops frequently to take new stereo images of the path ahead to evaluate potential hazards. The 3D views give Perseverance the ability to drive by itself and make its own decisions about where to drive without having to consult with Earth for every move. The HazCams can also tell scientists where to place the robotic arm. In addition, a suite of engineering cameras, specialty cameras on the robotic arms, and a new sample collection camera were added on Perseverance. Mounted high on Curiosity's mast is the mast camera, MastCam. The upgraded version on Perseverance is called MastCam Z. MastCam, like MastCam Z, uses a side-by-side pair of cameras for examining terrain around the rover. MastCam's 2 cameras are referred to as the right eye and the left eye. The right eye looks through a telephoto lens and can distinguish a basketball from a football from a distance of 7 football fields. They can both be combined to produce stereo views. They are both scientific and natural color imaging systems. The MastCam Z cameras, however, add zoom capability, whereas MastCam has 2 fixed focal lengths. The MastCam Z cameras have the ability to zoom, focus, acquire data at high speed, and store large amounts of that data inside the rover. MastCam Z has improved stereo imaging capabilities compared to Curiosity's MastCam. MastCam Z provides important advances in navigational and instrument placement capabilities. Both determine mineralogy of the Martian surface and assist with rover operations. In total, Curiosity has 17 cameras and Perseverance has 23. Both rovers have environmental monitoring instruments that gather all kinds of information about the Martian environment. Curiosity's instrument is called the Rover Environmental Monitoring Station, or REMS. It is a tool which sits partway up Curiosity's mast and is a Martian weather station. On Curiosity, REMS measures and provides daily and seasonal reports on atmospheric pressure, humidity, ultraviolet radiation at the Martian surface, wind speed and direction, air temperature, and ground temperature around the rover. The two booms record and characterize airflow from dust devils and dust storms. The corresponding instrument on Perseverance is the Mars Environmental Dynamics Analyzer, or META. META has increased scope and better data collection than REMS on the amount and size of dust particles in the Martian atmosphere. This will be extremely important when humans arrive on Mars. This will help scientists design spacesuits, helmets, structures for living, and food production. The Ingenuity helicopter checked in with META to determine wind speeds and direction before it set out on its historic flight. Both Curiosity and Perseverance examine the ground beneath and around the rover. On Curiosity, the instrument is called the Dynamic Albedo of Neutrons, or DAN. It helps the rover search for ice and waterlogged minerals beneath the Martian surface by firing beams of neutrons at the ground, then note the speed at which these particles travel when they bounce back. Hydrogen atoms tend to slow neutrons down, so an abundance of slower neutrons signals underground water or ice. The corresponding instrument on Perseverance is RIMFAX. RIMFAX doesn't fire pulsating neutrons at the ground, but rather ground-penetrating radar, which provides centimeter-scale resolution of the geologic structure of the subsurface. This is the first time that ground-penetrating radar is used on the surface of Mars. Previous GPR observations have been conducted from orbiters. The Curiosity rover uses the Multi-Mission Radioisotope Thermoelectric Generator, MMRTG, as a power source. It is the basis for the MMRTG now being used on Perseverance. The MMRTG is a power source that has been used for years to power spacecraft that have gone to the outer planets, and even the Apollo missions used it on the Moon. The Voyagers and Cassini spacecraft and more than 24 other spacecraft also use the MMRTG as a power source. The MMRTG on Perseverance is, however, slightly different than previous versions. It is loaded with 32 hot, silvery lumps of fuel wrapped in iridium. It contains a specially produced form of plutonium dioxide. After ceasing production for several years, the U.S. in 2015 once again began making plutonium-238, so the plutonium dioxide now used is fresh and is made in the U.S. The generator provides both electrical power and heat for the rover. The MMRTG will keep the rover's batteries charged year-round in all sorts of conditions and is expected to operate for at least 14 years. Curiosity continues to examine the Red Planet for information that will help scientists determine how humans will be able to survive on Mars. Perseverance added some more sophisticated instruments not found on Curiosity that future exploration spacecraft will be able to build upon.